Wasn't the planned path, as I've said many times before over the past few days, but regardless of the path taken, Oklahoma will be playing for a national championship starting tomorrow night. And OU beats James Madison 7-1 in what started off to be not the greatest start when G. Juarez gives up a home run on the very first pitch of the game, and it turns into a pitcher's duel for about three or four innings. Until the bats woke up in the bottom of the fifth, and that was kind of all she wrote from that point forward. And before I go any further, as I've said before, I've talked about Odyssey Alexander and what that girl, she put that team, that James Madison team, on her back all season long. I think she went over 1,000 pitches for not just for the entire tournament, including the World Series. And, you know, they mentioned that, you know, she got like a pitch hit her foot and like hurt her toes, and she lost a couple toenails. So I can only imagine losing one, losing two. Just saying that out loud hurts. And she still, through about half that game, was pitching one hell. She had one hell of a performance up to that point. But I would imagine a combination of that and just the you know, the fatigue, you know, the wear and tear of her arm, just like literally being the only pitcher for that team. And I don't care what happens the rest of the way, whether it's OU, Bama, OU, Florida State, I think you've got to seriously consider her for most outstanding player of the World Series of this tournament. I don't know how, you know, obviously Alo's going to be up there. Tiara Jennings might be up there, but just overall, you know, putting your team on your back like that. And she deserved that standing ovation from everyone. You know, OU fans, JMU fans, whoever was there. So, I know there's a handful of people out there who are not very happy with OU and OU fans on Sopo. It was like, but come on, guys. Like, if you watched the game, you saw the respect that was given. And listen, I am not the ultimate greatest ambassador for OU fans, like, because I am more than capable of being a jerk myself at times, but when it comes to this, when it comes to respecting talent and like what they've done on the field and like bringing Oklahoma pretty close to not achieving the ultimate goal when everyone assumed it was a shoe, including myself at some points, yeah, you've earned my respect. I think you've earned everyone's respect, and definitely a player that hopefully will not be forgotten, will go down the record books as one of the all-time greats in softball. So here we are. We await the winner of Florida State, Alabama. And I know there's, like I mentioned before the other night, you know, there's like controversy over how the NCAA handled moving the games. And I think when they made the wrong call letting Florida State and Bama go, or Florida State, Oklahoma State, excuse me, go really late a couple nights ago, no matter what decision they made, I think it was gonna like get, they were gonna get heat for it. So, could OU have James Madison played last night? Sure, but then you're asking Bama, Florida State to either play really late, or you give them an extra day of rest and they play today. So I think they made the right call. All said, when it's all said and done, both teams get good weather. Nothing is getting in the way of what's going on tonight. So weather's clear. So Florida State, Bama should be able to play a pretty, you know, no interference from weather tonight or anything like that. So we await our opponents for the next 2 or 3 days, Tuesday, Wednesday, maybe Thursday, depending how things go. I like Alabama, but you never know. Florida State, you know, they're recent national champs themselves. So whoever it is, it's going to be a hell of a series. All I know is good to see OU back in the championship game, or the championship final series, I should say, and I am looking forward to it. And was supposed to start tonight, but you know what? One day, not going to matter much. I have something else I got to take care of tonight, so thankfully no conflict of interest. And we'll see if I'm thinking about it. Don't hold me to this. I might do a watch-along for this. No promises, because it's just, I don't know if I'm going to have the same energy watching a softball game versus a football game. It's a different pace, a different watch, so I'm thinking about it. So don't hold me to it. If I decide not to, it just depends on, I might have too many distractions around me at the time. But something I'm considering, so we'll see where we go from there. Anyway, Boomer Sooner, waiting on some potential football news later this week. And we got the big barbecue next week for recruiting, so a lot of stuff built up for that. Hey, maybe a Bear that just decommitted from Georgia might show up. Who knows? You know, no guarantees, but that would be pretty cool. Y'all have a good one, Boomer Sooner. Congrats, girls. Donahue, you're amazing. Love you. Keep up the good work, because we're going to need all those bats against either Bama or Florida State. Y'all have a good one.